Hello, everybody. This is James LaRance, and I pray that God is richly blessing you through the Lord Jesus Christ, who came for us, shedding his blood, dying on the cross, being placed in a tomb, but being raised again from the dead for us, for the remission of our sins, and for our eternal life and our sanctification. All these things that God does through Jesus and not of ourselves. If you don't know Jesus, I pray that you will consider receiving him as your Lord and Savior today. Praise God. Okay, I'm going to go with my teaching now, and I'm going to be talking about what is the biblical process of amending broken fellowship. Now, I could have used the word mending broken fellowship. However, amending, it more so implies that there are suggests strongly that there are actions you must take, okay, to amend things. Okay, so let me talk about that. I'm going to talk about broken fellowship that can occur when people have what the world calls a falling out between each other. It can even be groups of people that have a falling out, families against each other, you know, like in the way back in the Old West times, it was the Hatfields and McCoys. And they had shootouts and so forth just constantly. They were constantly having a feud, as they called it. So people can amend these types of things. A falling out means that love has been lost between two people or two groups of people. When this happens, changes must be made to remedy this condition. This is especially true when the broken fellowship is with God himself. That is the most important thing you must amend, because broken fellowship with God can lead to broken relationship, in my opinion. Otherwise, what is backsliding all about? The word backslide means to slide back away from something. If you slide back away from God far enough, then you're without him, aren't you? But anyway, that's for another teaching sometime, but people have a controversy over that. Can you be lost once you've been saved and so forth? Well, you can certainly backslide. There's no doubt about that. And it states that in one of the scriptures I'm about to read here in just a moment. But remember, Jesus was called God manifest in the flesh. Okay. Now, I'm talking about how we must amend with God if we have backslidden away from him as a Christian. Okay, in 1 Timothy chapter 3, verse 16, it says about Jesus, just telling us about his character, you know, who he really was in reality, absolute reality. It says, "And without controversy, great is the mystery of godliness. God was manifest in the flesh, justified in the spirit, seen of angels, preached unto the Gentiles, believed on in the world, received up into glory." Okay, that is unmistakably a description of Jesus Christ, and it's calling him God manifest in the flesh. Now, Jesus spoke to people who had broken fellowship with each other in the book of Revelation. And actually, now let me start that over. Actually, it's talking about people who break fellowship with him specifically in Revelation. And it's found in Revelation chapter 2, verse 5, which says, "Remember, therefore, from whence thou art fallen." Okay, so now, let me start over, because, no, that is correct. I have another one. I've got a dot, 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 and then I read the rest of the, just one word off of it so it doesn't confuse from what the message I'm speaking. But this one is the full verse here. "Remember, therefore, from whence thou art fallen, and repent, and do the first works, or else I will come unto thee quickly and will remove thy candlestick out of his place, except thou repent." Okay, so this is talking about that people who have become fallen. So therefore, you know, as I was talking about before about backsliding from God, it says thou art fallen, and repent for this and do the first works, or I will come and remove thy candlestick out of his place, except thou repent. And he's speaking to the church in Ephesus at this time. Okay, they had obviously wandered from their walk with him. So doing the first works, in my opinion, means to fervently pray for forgiveness from backsliding and to ask Jesus to be their first love again, as he says to them in verse 4 of the same chapter 2 in the book of Revelation. I read a verse from there just a moment ago, but the one before that, okay? And I saved it for this reason, because he says to them, you have left your first love, okay? Some people like me, after I became backslidden in my teen years, I asked to be rebaptized by the pastor of churches I was attending and was even youth minister in. And this was an outward sign of my recommitment, my rededication to the Lord. Now, some people may look at that and say, well, I don't really need to be rebaptized again. Well, you know, that's really kind of up to you. If in your heart you know that simply reaching out to God and saying, God, please forgive me for this backsliding that I have committed, and restore my fellowship with you, God. And folks, you need to do it humbly and fervently. You must really mean it. You can't be playing games. I've said this in other messages, quite a few actually. And I said, you can't play games with God and say, you know, Lord, I want to rededicate again. I did it again. I went through a period of really bad sinfulness, and I need to repent and restore my fellowship with you. You can keep redoing it that if you're sincere, if it's for real, and you have just been overcome by certain sins several times over. Okay, because people do have sin problems who are Christians. They do indeed. So they can't just keep saying, Lord, well, I rededicate again because, you know, I went through these few months of relief, you know, being a rebel rouser, you know, or whatever the case may be. And I need your forgiveness, God. I need to restore my fellowship again. You know, if God knows you're just doing that so that you can hold on to sin and hold on to him at the same time, then you are, in a sense, you're tempting God. You're testing God's patience. And he will eventually say no more until you can repent and do it in true sincerity and remain, you know, in fellowship with me. Even though you may not be perfect and you may have an occasional sin, confess those sins to me. As it says in First John chapter 1, verses 9 and 10, if we confess our sins, he is faithful. He, God, is faithful to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Okay, so God will forgive us, but we can't play games with God, as I said. Okay, so now let me talk about when it comes to falling out between people, two people. Jesus said in Matthew chapter 18, verse 15 through 17, this about this. Now, here's where I have the dot, 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 so as not to confuse with that first word in the scripture passage here, because he kind of went through and was talking about other things, and then he said, moreover. Okay, well, I'll just go and say, moreover, if thy brother shall trespass against thee, go and tell him his fault between you and him alone. If he will hear you on the matter, of course, if he will hear you, thou hast gained thy brother. But if he will not hear you, then take with you two or three more people, that in the mouth of two or three witnesses every word may be established. And if he shall neglect to hear them, tell it unto the church. So, in other words, you have backup. They know about the situation. And may have even witnessed it. And they said, he says, hey, you guys come with me and talk to this man with me, if you would, please, because I truly want to be amended. You're not doing it to gang up on the guy. You see what I'm saying? No. You're doing it in true sincerity and saying, these other guys are saying something to the effect of, this is my opinion, but they would say something like, we know that you guys had a falling out and we really would love to see you guys back close together again and friends. So that's why they're there. And he says, if they will not hear you, you take it to the church. If he will neglect to hear the church, let him be unto you as a heathen man and a publican, someone to walk away from and to resist. Okay, so now that sounds kind of harsh, but you've done everything in your power is basically what Jesus is saying. Now, some people, you can't take them before church, but you can take them before another body of people, in a sense. In other words, you're simply trying to do a reunion with them, and so therefore you sometimes must have other people, family members, whatever the case may be, because if he's going to a certain church and you are going to a certain church, he's not going to go to your church. Okay, now I'm just saying that to be realistic about it. He's not going to do it. So you therefore have to look at another way to do that thing. But what he's showing is that you're making every effort to get the forgiveness from this guy. If you cannot, you know, and it may be real or imagined, you know, on his part about what you may have done or not done. So therefore, you have to receive forgiveness anyway. But you walk away with forgiveness for him, but you must not have fellowship because he can hinder you spiritually. Okay, so therefore, that's what that means. So don't leave anyone having unforgiveness in your heart about something. Even if they do, you must forgive, because Jesus said that. If you do not forgive, he said, neither will God forgive you your sins. You see what I'm saying? It's very serious, isn't it? So therefore, that's what you must do. I appreciate you listening. God bless you. And remember, Jesus loves you very much, and he is coming soon again to this world to reign and to take over and rid us of this horrible, sinful world state that the world is in, state of sinfulness, which is really bad, isn't it? Okay, thank you very much. Talk to you again soon. This is James Lawrence saying goodbye for now.